digital meter. That means load is applied over that particular specimen. Right now I will slightly increase the load with the help of this knob by opening it to the in the anti-clockwise direction. You can see the load can be increased when we open this knob. Now you can see the load is getting increases up to a certain limit, it will get increased, and at a particular limit it will get stopped and then it will decrease. At that point, that is the yield point process which takes place, or the yielding point process which takes place in the specimen of the tension test on mainstream bar. So you can see the load is increasing gradually and suddenly. Now you can see the load will get stabilized at a particular point, and after that it will get decreased suddenly. That point is called as yield point, and necking formation takes place into that specimen. Now you can see the load is getting stable at 75.64 or 60 kilonewton. Now the load will get suddenly decreased and necking formation takes place inside the specimen. Now you can see the load is getting decreased. Seventy-six is your maximum load.
झालं का ते राखायचं का आता कधी स्टार्ट कर सांगशील होते करणे एक फॉर्म चालू करू का करू का एक पॉज केलं होते का
Now you can see the specimen gets break at a particular load. So now we can lower down this jaw by using this downward button. And we will remove the specimen. So now you can see this is the breaked sample of mild steel bar. We have to take the deformed diameter of this bar. This is the original and this is the deformed diameter, and by using this we have to do the calculations. Now we will do the calculation part for this specimen or for this practical particular. So these are the observations which we have seen. This is the final gauge length 100 mm, initial gauge length is 80 mm, original area is 201.06 mm square, final area is 28.27 mm square. After the deformation, we have took the diameter and it comes as 28.27 mm square. Maximum load we have found out, while that is the maximum load at which the reading gets stopped, that is 78.920 kN. For calculation purposes, we have to determine three parameters, that is the percentage elongation, reduce in area and stresses. Okay, so basic aim of this practical is to find the stress, that is the load upon area, that is the maximum load upon the cross sectional area of this bar. Okay, so for percentage elongation, final gauge length FGL means final gauge length, IGL means initial gauge length upon its initial gauge length into 100, that is 100 minus 80 upon 80 into 100, which gives 25%. Then percentage reduction in area is A0 minus AF upon A0, original area minus fractured area upon original area into 100, which gives 201.06 minus 28.27 upon 201.06 into 10 to into 100, which gives the reading of 85. And last one is the stress, that is maximum load upon area. We have gotten this 78.920 kN load and the cross sectional area of the bar is 201.06, which gives 392.5 into 10 to the power 5 Newton. So Newton per mm. So these are the observation table. First observation, having load 48.920, original gauge length 80, extension 100, stress is 0.923 and strain is 0.20. Strain is nothing but change in original dimension, change in dimension upon its original dimension, that is the strain. Okay, so these are the observation, calculation and observation table for this particular practical.
So this is all about the tension test on mild steel bar. So what is the application for this practical, or what is the use of this practical while we are constructing the any type of structure? We need reinforcement, that is called as bar. As you can see, there are some reinforcement bars in RCC. So there are different types of diameter bars, 6 mm, 8 mm up to 32 mm, having the particular weight per unit length in kg. So these are the different types of bars having different diameters, and below that we are getting a grade of steel. Okay, for this particular practical we are using Fe415 grade of steel, whose yield strength is 415 Newton per mm square, ultimate tensile strength is 485 Newton per mm square, and percentage elongation will be 14.5. So finally, I want to conclude that we have performed a tension test on mild steel bar by using the universal testing machine. On this machine, we can take different types of experiment, or we can perform different types of experiments such as tension test, flexure test, then compression test, and shear test, single shear and double shear. That's why as n number of tests or more than one test can be performed on this universal testing machine. That is why it is called as UTM, Universal Testing Machine. So this is all about tension test on mild steel bar. Thanks a lot. Have a